energetic beta particles. Thereafter, let's see the procedure of autoradiography. Here, a flow diagram of the procedure is depicted. You can see the different steps here. At the first step, the cells are briefly exposed to a pulse of a specific radioactive compound, and the tissues are left for variable time. Then, after the exposure, tissue samples are taken, fixed, and processed for the further activity. Then the samples or tissue samples are sectioned into thin slices and overlaid with a thin film of photographic emulsion. And in this emulsion, the sections are incubated in the dark. The incubation time basically depends on the activity of isotope, the temperature, and the background radiation. Thereafter, the photographic emulsion developed as per the conventional photography. Sometimes the tissue sections need counter staining, which can be performed using Tolvidine blue. This is useful for the histological details of tissues. It must be taken care that stain must be able to penetrate the tissue but not have an adverse effect on the emulsion. Other alternate method is that pre-staining of the entire block of tissue can be done using osmium or any other suitable substance before the exposure to the photographic emulsion. The pre-staining avoids the need for individual post-staining of each slide. After the completion of this staining process, the position of spots or silver grains in the samples can be observed through microscopy or any other method. It must be noted that the spots are sometimes present in different plane of focus in the emulsion overlaying the tissue sections. The similar procedure is depicted here in a simple diagram. You can see the different steps of autoradiography in these diagrams. The first diagram, it shows incubation of cell with radioactive compounds. The compounds are incubated with radioactive elements. After the completion of exposure, cells were washed and fixed using some additives. After the fixation, the cells are dehydrated and embedded in wax or plastic, whatever would be suitable. The embedment of cell is necessary for the proper sectioning of the tissues. Or you can say they are making a thin slice, thin and suitable slice of tissue sample. Then these thin sections have to be attached over slides and fixed over these slides. The slides were then fit into the radiation sensitive emulsion in the dark. You can see the slide, and this part is the of our sample, and this slide or the section is surrounded by a liquid which is radiation sensitive, and this outer is the viewing vessel. After the completion of incubation period in the dark, the slides were developed, and now this slide is ready for the observation of black spot over the slide or section. Thereafter, let's see the photographic detection system in autoradiography. The photographic detection system are basically two types. First one is stripping film. Stripping film consists of an even layer of photographic emulsion on a supporting gelatin membrane. It is floated on water and then wrapped around the slide and forms very close contact as it dries. It has the major advantage of uniform thickness, but the disadvantage that the supporting membrane prevents counter staining of the section, and therefore the tissue block must be pre-stained before sections are coated. Whereas the second method is liquid photographic emulsion. This is the method which is routinely used, or you can say the more popular method. The liquid photographic emulsion method is simpler and much quicker to do, but the layer of the liquid emulsion can be slightly uneven in thickness as it flows down to the bottom of slide as it withdraws. For the most purposes, the slight variation is not important. In such cases, the liquid photographic emulsion detection system would be more convenient. Thereafter, let's see what are the applications of autoradiography. Autoradiography is basically a histochemical technique, and it is used for the localization of various biomolecules like DNA, RNA, proteins, or other molecules. It can be used as a tracer technique. It is used for tracing molecular movement in different organs. Let's see the limitations associated with autoradiography. The limitation of autoradiography is that all the substances at any particular site in a tissue is not being detected. Only that substance which has been introduced in a radioactive condition in vivo into the organism could be detected through autoradiography. The second limitation is the inability to precisely localize the isotope in the tissue, because sometimes what happens, the size of a spot which is formed due to the deposition of silver metal is greater than the organelle size, then it becomes difficult to precisely find out the location of the source of or the localization of molecules. And the third limitation is the lack of availability of suitable organic substances like hormones, vitamins, etc., in which the atoms of one of the constituent element is radioactive. To trace the mobility of this molecule like hormones or vitamin, it must be necessary that such substances should be available with one or more element with a radioactive label. In the absence of unavailability of labeled biomolecule, they could not be utilized for the autoradiographic study. Thank you.